Hello everyone, welcome back to another lecture on Aspen Tech channel. So in our last lecture, which was related to the introduction of Aspen Exchange design and rating, we had seen how to add the process equipments, the process requirements, how to add process components, and how to view exchange geometry, and we had seen one example. So today we will solve a real-time example, and in this example we have been given a benzene stream, which is a hot stream whose inlet temperature is 70 degrees centigrade, outlet temperature is 50 degrees centigrade, with inlet pressure 1.5 bar, pressure drop of 0.1 bar, and flow rate of 2000 kg per hour. On the other hand, in cold side, we have been given the toluene stream, which is entering at 25 degrees centigrade, for which we need to know the outlet temperature, inlet pressure is 2.5 bar, pressure drop is 0.1 bar, and the flow rate is 2000 kg per hour. And for this system, we will use or we will design shell and tube model. So click on new, select shell and tube, expand a bit and create it. And once after creating, this interface will appear. But obviously we need to first specify the process because we are doing that designing part. Obviously there are other parts as well like rating, checking, simulation, fine fouling. But we are concerned with the design, which is find the size of exchanger for specified process requirement. So what we need to do, we need to go to this input in problem definition. Number one is the headings, remarks. So we can add company name, location and so on. It's an optional step. Then in application options, obviously the calculation mode is designing. Location of hot fluid at shell side. Selection geometry based on US. It could either be SI. Calculation method, advanced. Then in hot side, we can either specify it as program by default or we can specify liquid no phase change, depending on the requirement of the process. But for so far, it is a very simple process. Then going to process data, and here we have to give the process conditions. Now we will specify shell side as benzene and tube side as toluene. And to convert the units to SI, we will click here and convert it to SI. And now first, we have been given the mass flow rate in kg per hour, not in kg per second. So either you can convert it to kg per second or simply change the unit by scrolling it down, kg per hour. Now we have to specify sky blue highlighted, like it is 2000 kg per hour. Once you specify it, it will be turned as white, as you can see. And for it, it is again 2000 kg per hour. So flow rate for both streams have been specified. Now what we need to specify the temperatures. 70 degrees centigrade is inlet temperature of benzene, 25 is the inlet temperature of toluene. So 70 degrees centigrade inlet temperature of benzene and 25 degrees centigrade inlet temperature of toluene. What is the outlet temperature? Obviously, we need to know at least one of them since we know the flow rate. Obviously, you know this concept MCPDT and we have already discussed it in our previous videos. I will give its link in the description. Then in the outlet temperature, 50 degrees centigrade, and obviously the other values will be computed automatically like the vapor mass fractions. Then the pressure, for it is 1.5 bar. And it has computed automatically, but we will label it as 1.4. And for it, it is 2.5 bar and the pressure drop is 0.1 bar for both the streams. After that, you can run. Obviously, you have specified the estimated pressure drops. Now, regarding these two, I will for the time being ignore these. And we will come back at these two points later. That's why these two are important to specify. Then, after specifying this, this has been a minimum information which has been specified. We need to go to this property data, and then in hot stream one composition, as I have told you that we need to scroll it down in physical property package and we have to select Aspen properties. So it will take the data from the Aspen Plus because it is linked with Aspen Plus by default. So after taking it, you will have to wait for a few seconds and then this will pop up. So you have to click on search data bank. It is the same as that of the component finding procedure in the Aspen Plus. And there are two components, benzene and then find now, and scrolling it down, this benzene is here. So add selected component, and as you can see, toluene is already here, so you do not need to find it out. After these, use selected components, and these two components are now available. Since one of the stream is pure benzene, one of the stream is pure toluene, so you either specify weight flow rate or percent or mass or mole flow rate percent, the answer will be same. So one and zero, since we are specifying the hot stream. So hot stream is benzene composition one, toluene zero. Similarly, going here in cold stream compositions, currently it's cross because we have not specified any component for it. And once specifying Aspen properties, this will come here. So benzene 0, toluene 1. And once after specifying, you can see there is no cross existing over here. Property data is completed. Process data has been specified. So click on this run button and again you will have to wait for a few seconds and then the results will come. So these are the three input warnings basically. Number one is related to the allocation of hot stream. A default allocation of hot stream to the shell side has been made. It is estimated that chances of this being correct are about 50%. Obviously, we know benzene is carcinogenic in nature. It is a hazardous fluid. So obviously, these type of fluids are usually not placed in the shell side. So the aspect exchanger design and rating obviously provide us this information that the fluid should be placed in the tube side. Number one. Number two, I had told you that we have not specified the maximum allowable pressure drop. Obviously, we need to specify this for a proper design. Then we have not specified the fouling resistance. These are the three warnings which have been obtained after running the model. So what we need to do, we need to go back to process data. Obviously, we need to specify some allowable pressure drop. Let's say it is 0.2 bar. And for this stream, it is 0.2 bar. And then we need to specify the fouling resistance. Let's assume it is 0.0001 square meter per Kelvin watt for this. And the same unit, same value for this. And from where to change the location of hot side, obviously, we need to go to this application option and location of hot fluid, we need to change it to tube side. And coming back on process data, now hot stream 1 is in tube side, cold stream 2 which is at shell side. So now simply you can run, but I will take you to one more thing that in hot stream 1 compositions, these are the property methods. So currently the property method selected is Pang-Robinson for benzene toluene mixture. If you want to select some other property package, which is of equation of state like SRK or LKP block, you can also select as well. So once after doing this, click on this run button, again wait for few seconds to run it. And now after waiting for few seconds, the results have come and you can see there are no warnings available in the system and the system is properly designed. So these are the few notes and advisory that the iterations, after 28 iterations, the system has been designed, it has been completed, and there are some information available. So what we need to do, first we need to go to this optimization path, and you can see the path number 4 has been selected. And in this path number 4, you can see there is no vibration, no unsupported tube lengths, design status is okay. And as you can see, among these all designs, there is no vibration, no problems, but the lowest cost is associated with design number 4. So that has been optimized or that has been selected in the system. Then in recap of designs, there are different design systems available over here. TEMA sheet, as you can see, and this is the overall sheet of the system. As you can see, 25 degrees centigrade was the inlet temperature of toluene, 70 was inlet temperature of benzene, 50 was outlet temperature of benzene, and the calculated temperature is 45.75. And as you can see, the system has been solved completely. And this is the sketch of heat exchanger which has been designed for this system. Obviously, we have not varied the material construction. We can also vary the material construction as well in this system by going into, if you see here, by going into console, which is here. And you can get the information over here that BEM, TEMA type B, bonnet bolted, or integral with tube sheet, E type, one pass shell, M type, bonnet has been selected. Location of hot fluid tube side. Earlier in the previous version, it was shell side. So there are basically two design steps available because first we have designed or we have given the allocation of hot side to the shell, hot fluid to the shell side. And this is tube side. Tube body, pitch, tube pattern, and you can see most of the things are same over here. So we can even vary the material of construction over here as well. And you can see the cost. It is almost the same, no difference in the cost which we have got. And in the overall summary, we can see the overall summary of this system. So this is the detailed design of the heat exchanger which can be done or which have been done using Aspen exchanger design and rating. So performance, heat transfer, these all are the things at which we can spend many time obviously, but Obviously, we have to keep the video short as well, and unnecessary delays. In Exchanger, again, in Exchanger geometry, we can see setting plan and tube sheet layout, and you can see it as well. You can print it as well. Then in tube sheet layout, you can even print it as well. And then in calculation detail, analysis along shell side and analysis along tube side. So this was the much simpler system, as you can see, and it has been solved very quickly, but not all systems follow these patterns. So in our next video, we will solve a much complex system, which will not be easy to solve. And we will solve that complex system, and that will enhance your confidence designing heat exchanger using Aspen Exchanger design and rating. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, and share this video and subscribe to the channel. Click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Thank you so much. Till then, it's goodbye. See you next time.